So you're looking at buying an old piano, traditional style. Your budget is only hundreds, not thousands, and you want to check whether it might be okay for your son or daughter or even yourself to learn on and play. Well, I'll give you a few pointers on things to look for. Obviously, if your budget is that low, you can't expect the earth, but here's a few things that you can just do to check whether it's going to be an absolute liability to you, and the tuner comes along and says, "How much did you pay for this?" And you say, "Oh, £20, what a bargain I got." And you say, "Well, no, actually, because you've paid to move it, and how much did it cost you to move it?" "Oh, about £300." "Well, the piano can't be tuned because it's got a big split in it, it's sounding terrible, and it's not worth repairing." So here's a few things to look for. First of all, what I want you to do is to play all the notes, but not just once. And when you've gone up the entire keyboard doing that, and check that all the notes play and repeat more than once, you then put the pedal on and you do the same again. Pedal on, the one on the right, you keep it on. The reason is sometimes if you put the pedal on, it means that it's just gravity that the parts are using to come back down, okay? When you just play like that, sometimes it's being helped down by weight, in effect, of something else, but you need really to check that the pedals are working. And you need to check that the notes are still repeating with the pedal on. That's the first thing. Once you've done that, by the way, you also notice how it sounds. If it sounds really rotten, like there's notes that sound really discordant, you play one note and it doesn't sound like one note, it sounds like three, be very wary. It could be that there's loose tuning pins. I'm going to show you the tuning pins now. Lift the lid. You have to ask the person selling the piano if you can look inside. And there, these are the tuning pins. These things here are what the tuner has to turn. Okay, and on some very old pianos, this part here, okay, this part is wood sometimes. In this case, it's metal, the frame, and you can't really see. But if you have lines going along from the pin, upwards or downwards, they're splits. You want to avoid the piano at all costs because it probably can't be tuned very well. Okay, so that's that. Next thing, what do the parts look like? Is it clean in there? You may not be able to take this part off. If you can, great, but possibly you shouldn't because it's not easy to get on and off and you might scratch the piano. But do the parts look pretty clean? This one's pretty clean for an old piano. This is one that I've actually, am selling because it's quite a good one. It's sold actually. But do they look as good as this or do they look really dirty? Can you see grooves in all these tops of the hammers where the strings have cut in to the hammer? Very gently, sort of very gently move that. Is it wobbling? Are some of them loose? That's the sort of thing. But if you do that, do it very gently indeed, just to see if they're loose and wobbling about. Okay, so that's one thing. The next thing I want you to do is I want you to go to this bottom part of the piano here. Now, you might find that there's a catch on that side and also on that side. You might find there's a little catch in the middle where you can sort of open that. Okay, it needs to be done very carefully. I am now going to open this little slidey catch here, like that, and the other side. Like that. This is the bit just above the pedals and I'm going to open this so that I can see inside. There we are. Now this part is called a soundboard. It's crucial. It's the structure of the piano. It's the heart. Now it's made of spruce, and what happens is if there's big splits in it, like big gaps, big lines, then again, that's a piano to be avoided, because it means you will probably have tuning problems. You may have horrible buzzes. There's all sorts of problems that can occur with splits in the piano. So avoid them like the plague if they're big. Sometimes on a piano that's £200 and everything else is absolutely fine, you can get a little line here and there. Okay, if the line, if the split is brown in sort of inside the split and it's small, you could ignore it. You could go for it if the rest of the piano seems absolutely fine. But if it's looks like a fresh split, if the sides of the split are light in colour, then avoid it. So there we are, and you can see that soundboard looks good. But if there were splits, it wouldn't be so good. The other thing to check, it's very rare actually, but this iron frame, just check that there's no splits in that either, because if there's a split in the iron frame that's up the top or at the bottom, that's big problems. Again, avoid like the plague. Okay, if that's structurally okay, you then go on just to look at the pedals. Check that they're sort of doing what they should do, that they're connected at both ends, you know, to the rods, and they're moving upwards or downwards like that, and that they're working. Okay, so that's the pedals, so you've checked that. The other thing you can check is these bridges. Now that's a bridge. They're the things that the strings actually sit onto. They sort of press on, and it's worth sometimes just checking that there's no splits in those either, because that again will lead to big tuning problems. And obviously check that all the strings are there. If there's a few missing, you know, and that goes for when you look in the top as well, if you see any missing or broken strings, it means that when the tuner goes to play it and tune it, you may get more broken strings. So that's something else to watch out for. I'm going to put this back now. Now there's something else that you should watch out for when you're going to look at an old piano like this, and that is its location. Now I'm going to show you this because I know that this radiator is never on, but if your piano has a radiator behind it with the pipes like that, forget it. Because if that radiator has been on, and often people say they're never on and they are, it's probably ruined the piano, okay? Pianos are made of wood. The wood expands and contracts. And if it goes dry when the heat is on and then swells up again when the heat is off, it's going to crack. It'll be out of tune. It'll be dreadful. Don't buy a piano that's right in front of a radiator next to a wood burner or near any heat source. Is it in a conservatory? Probably forget it. Is it being affected by direct sunlight? Probably forget it. It's all bad. And that really is a very, very, very basic summary of things to check for when you're looking at a budget piano. I'm talking about those under £1,000 really. You know, you need to check those things. They're the important things. The casework can look $1 million. You can't judge a book by its cover. And it's very possible and quite likely, if you only do that, that you could end up with a wreck or something that's really going to give you hassle for the rest of your playing days. If you've got the budget, I would go for something better. You know, I would possibly go for something round about £2,000 or £3,000, a good second-hand piano. Or if you've really got the budget, I sell the Yamahas here, sort of £5,000 or £6,000, but they're pristine and will see you up all the grades, Piano, an old piano like this probably won't see you up to grade 8 and beyond. So I hope that's given you a few pointers, and it's something I get asked about a lot. And of course, if you go and you check a piano and you think it might be okay for you, just as an extra safety blanket, get your local professional PTA registered piano tuner or technician to check it over for you. You might find it's well worth the extra, you know, £70 to £100 just to get them to check it. Okay, this is Matthew Goff. Bye for now.